Hi, welcome to Mowgli TV. Today we're going to talk about text in Resolume. I'm pretty sure you're aware of the text functionalities that Resolume has so that you can add titles, put announcements on, DJ names, and you can do it all on the fly, which is extremely handy. But something you might not know is that you can actually add specific titles to a specific video clip and keep them in a single clip so that you could have introductory text that goes with the video clip, and then when the clip comes to an end, there could be like a final credit list or something along those lines. So there's a lot of scope tailoring different bits of text along the timeline of your single clip, which is extremely useful, and it's very easy to then move it around through your decks, through your composition, or even you could export it to use in other software, or you could publish it to social media, which is extremely handy, as often you've got a video that all it needs is some quick titling and off you go. Well, you don't need to use After Effects or anything along those lines anymore. You can do it all within Resolume, which is a lot faster, a lot quicker, and a lot more fun. So we got this clip here, which has got a video of one of my modular synth performances, which I've just dropped here. It's got audio as well. It's gonna turn that down for clarity, and it's just a straight video to which I've added this effect here. So let's just switch that off. That is the video, nothing very exciting. And I want to export this for use in social media. So I want to add a title at the beginning of it, and then I'm gonna add some credits at the end of it, or probably just a like and subscribe kind of thing, because I'm gonna be posting this on my YouTube channel. First thing we're gonna do is go to our effects, type in text, and we can have the text animate, and we're going to drop it underneath the polarize effect. If we put it on top, well, we'll see what happens. That's something you might want to be doing, but not in this case. But this is something to bear in mind, the order of your effects, especially if you're putting text, is very important, as the text will also be affected by the effects that are after it. So this needs bit of consideration while you're organizing what you're going to do. So let's move the text animator underneath. And next, I'm just going to change this text to be the title, and I'm going to change the font to one of my liking. Next, we're going to change the colors of our text to whatever we want them to be. We can style the text with the new functionalities that Resolume has had in the latest versions, which is the outline color, outline width. So let's just bring a bit of outline width there, glow out, change that color. And now what we can do is actually start animating this so it goes with the clip itself. So click on the animate, open that up, and scroll down to see all the settings in there. And then what we're going to do is animate the opacity. So this is where the power lies. If you go to clip position, that means that whatever that animated parameter is doing will always be in sync with the timeline of the video clip that we've got there. So if we place that in, you'll see that you've got the marker there. It's our marker there. And all you need to do next is add an envelope. We're going to use the digital here. We're going to make that disappear. And we're just gonna eyeball it so that it stays roughly there. And basically what should happen now is that when we click on trigger our clip, we get our title appearing. And a good trick here to edit your envelopes is to actually make them bigger. So what we could do is widen this column. And as you can see, this allows you to be way more accurate when you're actually doing this kind of work. So now we can move it there, we can trigger it, we can see how long that stays on, see if it's to our liking. It's not as accurate as doing it with keyframing, but it's way faster, and it also allows you to keep this as something editable that you can change on the fly. So maybe that's still too long, so let's do a bit shorter, re-trigger it, and there you go. We've got a clip with a title that comes on and then comes off after a bit. Next is putting some credits maybe at the end of it. So let's just collapse this text animator, bring another one in, and I'll just do some sample text here. Let's change the font so that it matches our other one. And what we do now again is we animate it. So click on animate, expand it. And in the opacity, we're going to again go to clip position. Then we're going to add an envelope. Let's go to the digital again. And we're gonna just move this over here so it's at the end. And we're gonna get rid of that. And we want this to come towards the end of the clip. And to preview that, all you need to do is scrub on your clip so that it comes, and there you go. So that's it in a nutshell. There's way more things that you could do with this. You can actually do a lot of styling to your text and play with the animation and all that kind of thing, but I'll leave that up to you. And I hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial. There's a lot of scope in this, and it's way faster than doing it using timeline editing. And not only that, but you can actually see exactly what you're doing as you're doing. If you want to publish in social media, just use the render to file and export as in whatever format you might need, and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.